number six of those where we kind of came in sideways, got, you know, I don't think we got fouled on many of them, but, you know, we've got to make a stronger play to make something happen rather than hope for something to happen.
The bright spot here the last couple of ball games has been the play of Bridget Barrett. I thought she played well today. 14 points, 10 rebounds. She was active early on, particularly on the offensive glass again here today for the Firebirds.
Yeah, you know, she's always going to give you great effort. You know, her offense has come along the last two games, which is really going to help. You know, we had 21 points. The first quarter is how, you know, first quarter is how we wanted to play it. And obviously they're a good basketball team, and they kept grinding us defensively. And we felt good at halftime because, you know, it was us executing our stuff. And the way they play you defensively, you've got to make multiple efforts. You can't just walk out to the wing and say, throw me the ball, let me shoot it. They're denying stuff. They're physical with it. That's good. And when we did make a cut followed by another cut, we were able to free people up and skip the ball to the other side and get some shots. We just ran out of offense.
Yeah, that's been the story, trying to find some offense at times, and it's got to be frustrating because, again, you had some opportunities, you had some close looks, and particularly those layups really hurt that you can't finish at the rim.
Yeah, I mean, we got there, and it's not easy to do in a college game to finish there. You've got to really be, you know, really got to attack it and get on balance, and we were there, and we just didn't finish them. I mean, you know, and again, I don't have too many qualms with the shots we took, but 4 for 24 from three, you got to make those. You get a chance, you got to make a shot. You know, they're doing a good job defensively, but some of them where we got the ball into the lane and pitched out, you know, if you make two more of those, you know, you're right in the game. So it's, you know, we talked about that too. I mean, you know, as coaches, you always are trying to devise clever drills and let's do this and try this. And you know what? And it, like I said before, it came down to we didn't make our layups and we didn't make three-point shots when we had the chance to. And what do? You got to practice layups and three-point shots. You know, you got to practice shooting. And, you know, if you're anyone that's a basketball fan knows that you've got, you know, it's like a golf swing. If you're not, if you don't feel it, you got to get back in the lab and keep shooting. And the way our, you know, the way things are structured, if I gave them enough shooting drills in practice to get that shooting, we'd practice for 3.5 hours. So, you know, sometimes finding that the shooting gun and getting over there and getting a couple hundred shots up, so you feel the groove where you're shooting it well. You know, we've just got to get back to that. I mean, we've got, you know, I didn't have, like I said, there some of the people had really good looks. I didn't think we forced any 3-point shots for the most part. We just didn't make them.
I don't know. Ayanna Esther may have lost some confidence, I guess. I don't know. Her last two ball games, they're now 0-13.
Right, and that, you know, that's something you gotta wear. I mean, that's the thing when you play the game, the numbers are the numbers. After the game, you know, you either won or lost. You either made them or you didn't. So, you know, I'm sure she'll get back in there and work on it because there's opportunities and they're all, you know, she's a good shooter and the ball comes out of her hand. It looks like it's going in. Right now, it's not going in. So, you know, she got to work her way through that slump and along with some other people just getting to where we can make those shots.
Two huge games next week. I know you take them one at a time. First one up, Wheaton on Wednesday. You beat them here, and they have struggled a little bit without Annie Tate, so maybe a break there.
Yeah, they're always going to be tough, and it's been, you know, that seems like a long time ago, you know, December 1st. And they had a kid that stepped in when Tate went out that was scoring like crazy for a while, but then what happens obviously is the league makes its adjustments and I'll look at what we did against them in December, but I need to look because they're different without Tate. Obviously it takes a 15, 18, 20 point a game scorer out of it. You know, it's not a zero sum where they don't get any for that because other kids have stepped up and Swider's awful good player, and so they're a little bit bigger, but you know, I was pleased with our, you know, I thought our defensive effort was strong. We didn't make too many mistakes that cost us baskets, and you know, we held them to 36 or 37%, and they're one of the top field goal percentage teams in the country. And I thought if we didn't turn it over, like I said, we turned it over 12 times. We just didn't make enough shots to make that help.
Well, let's regroup. Let's get it together. There's an opportunity Wednesday waiting for you down at King Arena, trying to get a victory over a struggling and scuffling Wheaton team.
Let's turn the page. We need to get to February. January wasn't so hot.
No, it wasn't. Let's get to February.
We can start over in February. Here we go.
All righty, Tim.
Thanks,
thank
Johnny.
You. I appreciate it. Tim Bernero, head basketball coach here at Carthage College for the women who fall here today, 55-46. Stay tuned. We've got men's basketball coming your way. We'll start the broadcast in about 10 minutes or so. Meanwhile, John Weiser saying good afternoon from the Tarble Arena, where Carthage fell here today in the women's side, 55-46. Stay tuned. Men's basketball coming your way in just a bit.